Overnight, Ukrainian forces pushing Putin's army back closer to his own borders in northeast Ukraine, retaking more than 30 villages around Kharkiv. Ukraine releasing a video Tuesday that it says shows a strike on an advanced Russian tank in the area. And in the east, Russia's advance slowed. This video, posted on May 9th, showing the destruction of Russian military equipment, according to the Ukrainian military. U.S. officials now warning the war may still get worse.
The next few months could see us moving along a more unpredictable and potentially escalatory trajectory. And the current trend increases the likelihood that President Putin will turn to more drastic means.
Innocent civilians continue to bear the brunt of Putin's war. Local police releasing this video, saying the woman was in her yard when the force of a strike nearby threw her yards into her own basement. We met Natasha in Malorogan near Kharkiv, whose village was occupied by Russian forces for more than 2 months.
How did they treat you?
There were cases of rape, she tells me. They killed one man, they shaved one woman's head and cut her with a knife. Investigators are now collecting evidence of what appear to be multiple war crimes. Alexander Filchikov is the lead prosecutor for Kharkiv.
How does it end?
There is no other end besides victory, he says, because we stand for the truth. America now signaling growing support for Ukraine, the House voting to send a $40 billion aid package to the Senate.
The Ukrainian people are fighting the fight for their democracy and in doing so for ours as well.
Well, some rather sobering figures from the UN this morning. The number of people who fled the country since Russia's invasion is now approaching 6 million. The UN also saying the real number of civilians killed in Ukraine since the beginning of the war is, quote, thousands higher than the real number.